大家好，我是丽丽。我今天尝试一下，就是先读汉语，完了之后我再读英文，这样子，看效果是什么样子的。好，我今天读一个故事，是我就是喜欢我。完了之后，我想试一下，这样让大家能看到这个会不会效果好一点。好，我开始读了哈。我好幸运啊！青蛙弗洛格一边欣赏着自己在水中的倒影，一边说：“我漂亮，会游泳，跳水又比其他人跳得好。我是绿色的，而绿色是我最喜欢的颜色。这世上最好的事就是做一只青蛙。那我呢？”小鸭问。“我是白色的。”难道你不觉得我也很漂亮吗？才不呢！弗洛格说：“你身上没有绿色，但是我会飞呀。”小鸭说：“而你又不会。”哦，是吗？弗洛格说：“我从没有看你飞过，我是有点懒。”小鸭说：“但是我真的可以飞，你看，它跑了几步。”用力地扇动翅膀，然后小鸭从地面升起，优雅地飞向天空。它飞了几圈后，降落在弗洛格面前的草地上。太棒了！弗洛格大叫，崇拜地说：“我也想要飞。”“你不行。”小鸭说，“你没有翅膀。”说完。得意地回家了。于是，弗洛格一个人开始练习飞行。他向前跑了好几步，然后张开手臂上下拍打。但是，不论他怎样努力，就是没有办法飞离地面。弗洛格灰心丧气了。我是一只没有用的青蛙。他想。我连飞都不会，真希望自己也能有翅膀。突然，弗洛格想出了一个聪明的办法，他相信只要是小鸭能做的，他也能。弗洛格花了一个星期的时间，用一块旧床单和一些细绳做了一对翅膀。他终于可以做一次试飞啦。他爬上河边的山丘，像小鸭一样跑了几步，然后张开手臂跳向天空。开始，他真的像鸟儿一样在天空中盘旋了一会儿，但是不久，翅膀断了，他就像石头一样落下来。啪的一声，掉进河里，这至少还算是安全降落。老鼠看到弗洛格狼狈地从水中爬出来，你要知道，青蛙是不会飞的。他说：“那你呢？”弗洛格问。“当然不会。”老鼠说：“我又没有翅膀，但是我很会做东西。”弗洛格在回家的路上一直想着这件事，他打算去问问小猪。弗洛格到小猪家的时候，小猪正从烤箱里拿出一个蛋糕。小猪，你会不会飞？弗洛格问。当然不会啦，小猪说。在天上，我可能会想吐的。那你会什么？弗洛格问。会很多东西呀。小猪骄傲地回答：“我能做世界上最好吃的蛋糕，而且我很漂亮，我全身是粉红色的，粉红色是我最喜欢的颜色。”弗洛格不得不承认，这些都是事实。我打赌，我一定也可以做蛋糕。弗洛格回到家后想着，他将所有他能找到的东西。都丢进碗里， 像小猪一样进行搅拌。再把搅拌好的东西丢进锅，然后放到炉子上。看吧，弗洛格心想，我的蛋糕一定很好吃。但是没过多久，一股浓烟从锅子里冒出来，发出很难闻的味道。蛋糕烤焦了，我连蛋糕都不会做，弗洛格觉得非常伤心。他跑去找野兔。野兔，我可不可以跟你借一本书？弗洛格问。你认识字吗？野兔惊讶地问。不认识，弗洛格说。或许你可以教教我。你看，野兔说，这是字母 O， 这是字母 A， 这是字母 K， 还有这……好了，知道了。弗洛格没有耐心听完，就夹着书跑回家了。弗洛格舒舒服服地坐下来，把书打开，但是书上充满了陌生的符号，弗洛格一个字也不认得。一个小时过去了，他一点儿也没有变聪明。我再也不要看这本书了。弗洛格说，这太难了，我只是一只既普通又愚蠢的青蛙。弗洛格沮丧地把书还给野兔。怎么样？野兔问，你喜欢吗？弗洛格遗憾地摇摇头，我不认识字，不会烤蛋糕，不会做东西，也不会飞，你们都比我聪明，我什么都不会，我只是一只普通的绿青蛙，弗洛格哭着说。可是弗洛格啊，野兔说，我们也不会飞呀，也不会烤蛋糕或做东西，也不能像你一样的游泳和跳跃，因为我只是一只兔子，而你是一只青蛙，但是我们大家都爱你。弗洛格走到河边，望着水中自己的倒影，陷入了沉思。这就是我，他想，一只穿着条纹泳裤的绿色青蛙。突然间，弗洛格感到非常愉快。野兔说的对呀，他想，真幸运，我是一只青蛙。他快乐地一跳，一个很大的青蛙跳，这可是只有青蛙才能做到的呀。他感觉自己像在飞。这个汉语的我读完了，我现在给大家读一下英文的。还是这一个故事，就是我喜欢我，英文就是说 Frog is a frog， 是不是？让大家看一下，这就这样看吧。How lucky I am, said Frog, admire his reflection in the water. I'm beautiful, I can swim, and jump better than anyone. I'm green, and green is my favorite color. Being a frog is the best thing in the world. 'What about me then?' asked Duck.I'm all right. Don't you think I'm beautiful too? No, said Frog. There's no green on you at all. But I can fly, said Duck. And you cannot. Oh, yes, said Frog. I have never seen you fly. I'm a bit lazy, said Duck. But I can fly. Watch.She took a run up and flapped her wings noisily. Then, suddenly, Duck rose from the ground and flew gracefully into the air. She flew around a few times and then landed on the grass in front of Frog.Fantastic, cried Frog, full of admiration. I want to fly too. You can't, said Duck. You haven't got any wings. And she went home feeling happy. When Frog was alone again, he started to practice flying. He took a long run up and flapped his arm widely up and down, but no matter how hard he tried, he couldn't get off the ground. Frog was disappointed. I am a useless frog, he thought. I can't even fly. If only I had wings. Then Frog had a clever idea. Whatever Duck could do, he could do too. For a week, Frog worked hard with an old sheet and some string. At last, he was ready for his first test fly. He went to the hill by the river. He took a good run up, just as he had seen Duck do. Then he leapt into the air with outstretched arms. He hovered in the air for a few seconds like a real bird, but then the wings ripped and he dropped like a stone. He fell in the river with a splash. At least it was a soft landing. Rat saw Frog stump out of the water. You must know that Frog can't fly, he said. Can't you fly? Asked Frog. Of course not, said Rat. I have no wings, but I'm good at making things. Frog thought about this on his way home. He would ask Pig as well. Pig was taking a cake out of the oven as Frog arrived. Pig, can you fly? Asked Frog. Certainly not, said Pig. I would probably get airsick. What can you do then? Asked Frog. All sorts of things, replied Pig indignantly. I can make the best cake in the world, and I'm beautiful. I am pink all over, and pink is my favorite color. Frog had to admit that this was true. I bet I can make a cake too, thought Frog when he was back at home. He threw everything he could find into a bowl and began to stir, just as he had seen Pig do. Then he threw everything into a pan and put it on the stove. There you see, thought Frog. My cake will be delicious. But after a while, smoke began to pour from the pan and a smelled awful. The cake was completely burnt. I can't even bake a cake, thought Frog. Sadly. He went to visit Hare. Hare, may I borrow a book from you? Asked Frog. Can you read? Asked Hare, surprised. No, said Frog. Perhaps you could tell me how. Look, said Hare. This is an O, and this is an A, and this is K, and this... Okay, I get it, said Frog impatiently. He ran home with the book under his arm. He made himself comfortable and opened the book, but the pages were full of strange scribbles. Frog couldn't understand a word. An hour later, he was none the wiser. I will never read this, said Frog. It's much too difficult for me. I'm just an ordinary, stupid frog. Sadly, Frog returned the book to Hare. Well, Ask Hare, did you enjoy it?
Frog shook his head sorrowfully. I can't read.
He said, I can't bake cake, I can't make things, and I cannot fly.
You are all much cleverer than me. I can't do anything. I'm just an ordinary green frog, he thought.
But frog, said Hare, I can't fly either. And I can't bake cake and or make things. I can't swim, leap like you do, because I am a hare. And you are a frog, and we all love you.
Deep in thought, Frog went to the river and looked at his reflection in the water.
That's me, he thought, a green frog with a stripy swimming trunks.
Suddenly, Frog felt very happy. He is right, he thought. I'm lucky to be a frog. And he leapt for joy, a big frog leap.
As only frogs can do, he felt as if he was flying.
好，这个故事读完了。如果你们喜欢的话，就给我点赞、订阅和分享吧。谢谢。好，拜拜。